Kevin, were you a good amateur?
I was decent amateur.
You turned pro. Why?
I got in trouble.
How'd you get in trouble?
Breaking in car.
And you got busted?
Yeah.
And then you turned pro?
Yeah, the judge said, what you going to do? I told him, I'm going to buy.
But what did the judge say?
He said, all right, he let me out.
Wow, you got a lucky break.
Yeah.
So what? So you, as a pro, you had about 22 fights, right?
Yeah.
How many wins?
I had like 16 wins, 17.
16 wins? Who was your favorite fighter growing up?
I told you, my dad.
LP Morgan?
Yeah.
He had he had 100 knockouts.
Yeah.
How did about 115, 120 fights or something?
Yeah, 200 something.
200 fights?
Yeah.
Wow.
I want to add to that too after you finish with Kevin.
Okay. How is your dad physically after 200 fights? No damage? Could he take it all?
Yeah, he took it all.
That's amazing, Kevin. How come you only had 22 fights? Why didn't you fight 200?
Because I got in trouble.
Even later, what happened this time?
Selling drugs.
Oh, man. Now, when you were a boxer, you're very famous. You know why? Because you're the only guy that both the Crips and the Bloods said, don't mess with this guy, he's a boxer. Let him do his thing. Right. Tell me about that. You were in Crenshaw, right?
Yeah, I was on Crenshaw.
And the Crips and the Bloods didn't like each other.
No.
But they liked you.
But the Bloods is the more better getting money than Crips.
I don't know about that.
I do.
I don't. But I'm saying they both respected you and they didn't mess with you.
No, I had it my own way. I could fight.
But they respected that.
Yeah.
Now,
I knew both sides.
In the history of boxing, how big was your dad? How famous? Like?
In Mexico, they call him El Bucanero. Black pirate.
The black what?
El Bucanero, a black pirate.
He was a black pirate?
Yeah.
100 knockouts. Most fighters today only fight 20 fights, 30 fights.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
He had dynamite in his hands.
Yeah.
What made your dad so strong? Was it God-given or did he lift weights?
I don't know. He just had a punch.
So if someone broke into your house, who would they be worried about? You, your mom, or your dad?
Probably Sharon. Sharon, yeah. the
your
sister.
Mom?
Sharon.
My mom was out there.
She was out there.
Sharon, yeah. She used to ride the bus every day.
Rusko, Sharon.
Yeah, my daddy was gone in Mexico 10 years.
How old were you when you went to Mexico?
She went to Mexico, I was like 5 or 6.
So you came back when you were 16?
No, I went to Mexico when I was 7.
And you stayed with him?
Yeah, I stayed a month.
Over. And you didn't pick up Spanish?
I did. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis.
That's because your dad knocked him out and the ref kept counting. That's like, you heard it so many times, it was easy for you.
Yeah,
Diaz. That's pretty good. So let me ask you this. In your opinion, besides your dad, who's the greatest fighter of all time?
You gotta say Muhammad Ali.
Greatest of all time?
Yeah. Ali.
Why Ali?
I'll tell you why.
Because he did something nobody did. He had his hands down.
Well, not only political, but the dude fought all the eras. He fought the best in the 60s, Floyd Patterson, Oscar Bonavina, George Savalo, Sonny Liston, you know, Jerry Corey, who was underrated, Joe Frazier, Ken Norton, Rod Lau, Ernie Shavers. He fought all the eras.
Yeah.
In every era, the top, and didn't duck nobody.
And when they thought his career was over, he came back and did it again.
Exactly.
George Foreman.
Foreman's a bad boy. Buster Mathis. But Foreman, I like Sonny Liston. That's a bully. He tried to have that same.
Joe Frazier.
Joe Frazier, bad boy.
Okay. Mike Tyson in his prime, Muhammad Ali in his prime. Who would have won?
Well, I'm going to say,
I'm going to go with Ali.
I'll tell you why. Because Ali's going to move for the first 4 or 5 rounds. Tyson's going to catch his air after 3 or 4 rounds. And Ali is smart, you see.
Okay.
Just like Joe Frazier.
How would Mayweather do in that era if he fought against Sugar Ray Leonard or Durant?
Mayweather would be great in that era. Great. Now, I'm going to favor, now listen, I love Floyd, but Tommy Hearns, I think Styles make a fight. I think Hearns is big and long.
Durant,
inside fighter.
I think Mayweather would have beat Durant.
What do you think, Kevin? Mayweather, Durant, who would have won? Mayweather, Tommy Hearns?
Everybody box together, yeah. But not Tommy Hearns, though.
That's tough.
Tommy.
What about Sugar Ray Leonard?
Sugar Ray is too many combos, but
exactly. I agree.
Yeah.
I agree with that, too. And Sugar Ray could adapt. He adapts, you know.
Well, okay.
Even when Sugar Ray fought Floyd Sr., Floyd was a great defensive master. Floyd took 8 or 9 rounds, you know. But Sugar Ray, like, I finally caught him. Yeah. You know, and Floyd learned from his dad. You know, Floyd got that catch and shoot, and Floyd Sr. was very underrated. Kevin sparred with Floyd Sr.
You sparred Floyd Sr.?
He took him over to the bracket. Tell him how you took him to the clouds, Kevin.
Okay? Oh, yeah, I took him to the good part. You go to the good part. And then go up to the dormitory.
Yep.
Oh, I'm in the clouds. I thought he was in the clouds. See, he can run fast on the...
How good of a fighter was he?
He was New York fighter. He just boxed.
He taught his son great, though. His son won the best ever.
Roger taught him that shit.
You think Roger?
Roger was the best.
You know who's Roger's coach?
Jesse Reed.
Jesse Reed's a great.
He already knew how to fight when he came here.
Oh, okay.
Jesse Reed had Roger, and he had Bruce Curry at the same time. I remember that whole camp.
He also had
Billy Baxter and Jesse Reed.
Living La Vida Loca. What was that one?
Roger beat up the whole gym.
Wow.
All sides. The whole gym.
You know, Roger used to always tell me, I used to beat the shit out of Freddie Roach. That's what Roger told me. I wasn't there.
Roger beat up everybody.
The Black Mamba.
Black Mamba.
The only one he couldn't beat was
Chavez told me, man. He was in jail. Chavez was left to the body.
Yeah, but he's great on that.
Hey, do you like Gervonta Davis?
Who?
Gervonta?
What about him?
Do you like him?
Oh, I love him.
Yeah, Tank?
Yeah.
What about Tank and Ryan? Who do you like?
Tank.
I'm going to go with Tank.
Kevin, Tank or Ryan?
Tank. The baddest welterweight out right now, I'm telling you right now, is Boots Dennis.
29-0, 27. Him and Virgil is a big one. He wants to fight Crawford. He wants to fight. He's really from Philly.
Boots Dennis is the baddest fighter out right now in the world weight division.
Him and Crawford?
Right? No, yeah. You got size. You got speed.
Him and Crawford, who wins?
No, that's a hell of a fight.
That's
a hell of a fight.
And listen, let me say this. Crawford has a little more experience. But outside of that, skill set wise.
You ready, bro?
Yep. All right, good seeing you guys. Woo-wee. Stay up. Right, keep up doing your thing. Kevin, we'll see you soon.
All right.
Okay, you're back to lightweight. Always reporting.
Yes.
Kevin Morgan in the house. Tell me about his dad really quick.
LC Morgan, man, listen, man, he trained me. Mm-hmm. He trained everybody in the neighborhood growing up. That's what he did. LC was, you can have one average fighter try to turn you pro. LC was about the money.
Why not? Hey, it's a business.
Yeah, great fighter, man. I mean, like I said, look at his resume, man. Fought back in the early 60s, late 50s, 70s. Great guy.
200 pro fights. Crazy.
200 pro fights, man. Went to Mexico.
Still had his wits and everything.
Still had his wits, man. You know, he was slick, man. You know, he had that cross guard a little bit. He was a hell of a boxer puncher, man.
His son told me he had to go to Mexico because the mafia wanted him to throw a fight and he wouldn't do it. And for 10 years, he was in exile.
He was.
The mafia did run the sport. That's why it was very hard. It's still hard to get corporate sponsors because the black eye that it has still lingers.
It does. And it's really, really true.
But his dad is really accomplished, but doesn't get the recognition like other guys. Why is that?
You know what? You know, it's underrated. Some people just like, they say, you know, Larry Holmes just gets the recognition of Ali. It's hard to follow a guy like that. Sometimes, you know, people just overlook. There's so many great fighters in the 60s, man. In this case here, he's kind of in the shadow of a lot of guys. Look at his record. Over 200 fights.
That was before TV, before he had a chance.
Exactly.
Before social media.
Legendary.
Imagine if they did a montage, if they had it all on there. 100 knockouts in a row, and you see everybody going to sleep. He'd be sponsored by NyQuil in 2 minutes.
Always been around, man. Like I said, he's a great guy.
Coach, tell people where to follow you.
HammerFist_boxing. You can always follow me. You know, I do the boxing, self-defense. We do it all.
Come visit you at Fortune Gym.
I'm here 24/7.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Nelly Suckback reporting.